If you have an open statement you'd like to make, you can do that at this time. It's an honor.
Well, thank you, Mr. Chair. If I could, I'd like to press a couple things. First of all, my name for the record is John Steen, the manager, partner, director of the senior group. With me is Richard Kellar, one of our senior chief consultants in Medicaid policy, Medicaid policy. And I just want to park the record on one thing. I just want the committee to make sure before you make a vote, you know, we respect the taxpayers, representatives, and citizens of the state. We want to have, we respect the opinion of this committee or anybody. But I would ask that you just read our response or look at it, because it is not accurate to represent what you spend your money on the taxpayer. If you look at page 20, section 3 of this RFP is very detailed. We've been on a lot of projects and states, and we know what states ask, but you ask for a very comprehensive Medicaid audit, a Medicaid reform, alternatives, solutions to give the body ideas to come up with solutions for hopefully the next healthcare reform package you're going to put together the second next, coming into the next session. You ask for that. We, in detail, with our team, we met, we huddled, we spent weeks to look at every section of 3.0, every section, and we identified to look at the age-blind and disabled populations, to look at the financial projections of the budget, to identify the population where we could find savings so that we could make sure we keep in our recommendations, keep the quality in the right direction, and take care of the population you need to, at the same budget neutrality as what the recommendation of the RFP is. So we have that in mind while we're responding. We have experts, we have a doctor from MIT on our team, Dr. Oliver, who's really good with healthcare finances. Ran a private sector healthcare company. And we have someone from Harvard, a mathematics expert, that's going to look at CPT codes and find out where cost of outpatient facilities, inpatient, and what the differences are between hospitals. And we're going to present, in no question in my mind, to the task force, a very comprehensive report. This audit idea, I want to make sure we clarify, this is nothing but a screening of the eligibility beneficiary files to determine, as the majority wanted, to identify if there's issues of eligibility, that there's questionable issues. Maybe properties outside of the state of Arkansas. Maybe residences outside. Maybe with public databases. Maybe deceased that are on the roads. We have a primary care case management system. We pay doctors to take care of residents and individuals. Maybe the deceased roles haven't caught up to your system. We want to look at that first and then identify for you from the task force. You've got some leakages and some problems. We have experts on our team that know these issues well. And we agreed through the contracting process with Jill and with Martin, which I gave them a lot of credit because we just had a couple days of a lot of discussions. It's not easy for me as the managing partner to agree to a contract that says the majority of the task force has to agree on October 1st to this report, or we're going to be assessed a $1,000 fine after the 14 days. I mean, it's a political organization, but we're okay with that, because we know we're going to work together, Democrat or Republican. And that's why we run this, in our opinion, because we bid on projects that, you know, in Texas, I just want to say, in Texas, we have a team there now, this RFP is very similar. It was a comprehensive RFP to look at the entire child welfare services in the state of Texas. We've been against the best of them. There were 30 companies. And one of the individuals who got 7 of the votes of the company was one of the competitors. And we won that. And I want to read to you in our proposal. One of the things that after our assessment recommendation from March to July, because the commissioner and the legislature needed to know right away what some of these issues were. The statement that was in the paper after our presentation in one of the Boston Statesman papers. In Austin, this, in our report, we've quoted a lot of resources, as the RP said, give us some background on what you've done. And I'm quoting, the Department of Family and Protective Services hired a consultant, the Steaming, to conduct a top-to-bottom review of child protective services. Millions of dollars in that budget, by the way. The result was remarkably informative, 475 five-page report filled with details on how the agency operates, what's not working, and how to fix it. In our proposal, we're also going to give you ideas on the alternative solution for Medicaid reform package. And I want to address this on home issue. The RFP calls for, I know how aggressive this time period is. We, our team knows, we are going to do everything we can to make sure we meet that date, and especially knowing there's a performance issue. We need to do this for them. But I will tell you that when we bid on this project, I care about the taxpayers. I was a commissioner of Health and Human Services. I was the only commissioner of the United States that kept Medicaid funding flat for 4 years. But I will tell you, without depriving the quality of service for people, with making sure we help, we look at more community alternatives, less costly alternatives. And I know what it means to make sure you protect the taxpayers. And our team does, and that's why I hire consultants that are fiscally responsible. So the final thing I would say is October. It's so important that you get this full, complete report by October. And we've got to work with everyone. But we're not going to bid. We didn't bid after October for specific service, but what the RFP says is, will you be available at the call of the task force? Will you be available to come here to testify? Will you be available? Absolutely. All the way until the next year if we have to. We'll be here. That's how we operate. But we didn't feel we would go beyond that $1 million plus dollars, because at the end of the day, I've been saying to the committee and the task force, we don't have to write the waiver. Richard Kellogg's written waivers. I've written waivers. You can go to CMS's website. There's an 18-page template. Fill it out. Maybe the Department of Health, or your Department of Health and Department here, Human Services, can take care of this. Why do you have to spend any more money? We're going to give you one heck of a report, in my view. And you're going to have a lot of ideas and options. And at that point, we would discuss, if the RFP says, after the final report, there would be a discussion from the committee task force on whether they want to continue to have you offer services. And that's what our bid was about.